Welcome back to the Make or Break Society. In this one, we're going to install Acer SX2 on RetroPie. With this, you can play PS2 games on the Raspberry Pi 4 and 5. After spending weeks looking for information on how to get PS2 working on RetroPie, I finally got Acer SX2 on and found that it was actually really easy to do. There's just not much documentation on how to do it. Before we get into the install, I have a few shoutouts to people who made this a heck of a lot easier. First shout is to Forzid on Reddit, r/RetroPie, for the main documentation. The next shoutout goes to, I'm not even going to attempt to pronounce this, on GitHub for the fork of RetroPie extras that we're using. And the last shout out goes to Life in the Fast Lane on Reddit r/RetroPie for the kernel changes needed. Links to all three posts will be down in the description. Just a quick reminder before we get into it. I'll be giving away one of these two PS Pi version 6s once I hit 1,000 subscribers. So if you like this video and you don't want to miss the giveaway announcement, make sure to get subscribed. First thing you're going to need is a Raspberry Pi 4 or 5 running RetroPie 64-bit. There's no official image for this, so you're going to have to manually install it. I have a video here on how to do it on the Raspberry Pi 5, but the process is the same for the Raspberry Pi 4, except you select Raspberry Pi 4 in the imager right here. Once you have that done, boot up your Raspberry Pi. Step 1 is to SSH into your Raspberry Pi. I'm going to assume that you already know how to do that because you've already got RetroPie installed manually. If you don't, you can review my video on installing RetroPie manually as I walk through it there. Step 2 is to make sure you're up to date with all of your packages by entering the following command. Once that's done, we're going to edit your boot config to use kernel 8. Type the following command. Scroll down to the bottom of the file, and you're going to add these two lines after bracket all bracket. Once you've added those two lines, hit Control X, and then Y when you're asked if you want to save, and then hit Enter with the save location. Now we're going to install Vulkan with the following command. When you're prompted during the install, hit Y to accept. The next step, we're going to install RetroPie extras by entering the following commands one at a time. Now, when this window pops up, you're going to make sure that Choose which modules to install is selected, and hit Enter. Now highlight ethersx2.sh, press the spacebar to select it. Feel free to select any other modules you wish to install by highlighting them and press spacebar. Once you've got all the modules you want to install selected, hit Enter, and then Enter again. Then the right arrow key and enter again to exit. Now we're ready to run the EtherSX2 install script. Enter the following command, and when the warning pops up, hit enter. Now at this screen, we're going to go to Manage Packages, EXP, then scroll all the way to the bottom and highlight EtherSX2 and hit enter. Then hit enter again on install from source and select yes. After it's done installing, select back three times to get back to the main menu, and then select configuration/tools. Scroll down to Samba and click OK. Then click on Install RetroPie Samba Shares. Once it's done, select back a few more times and perform reboot. If your Pi doesn't reboot after, enter this command. Technically, that's it for installing EtherSX2. But if you actually want to use it, you're going to need the BIOS and some PS2 games. The file that you need for the BIOS is this. You'll have to dump this on your own from a PlayStation 2 like I did, or a quick Google search can probably help you. Once you have it, connect to your Pi via FTP, or by typing ../ your Raspberry Pi's IP address like this. Once in, your BIOS goes in this location. And your ROMs go here. Once you have both the BIOS and the ROMs transferred, switch over to RetroPie, open the main menu by pressing Start, then go to Quit, then Restart Emulation Station. Once that's done, PS2 should show up in your games list. You'll now see PS2 listed as an option, and your games will show up there. When you launch a game for the first time, it'll ask you what you want to use as the default emulator. Select EtherSX2, and your game's gonna boot. Performance of PS2 games is decent on the Pi 5, and from what I've been reading, it's also decent on the Pi 4 with some tweaks. As you can see playing Crash here, that the average FPS that I'm getting is between 45 and 55, and that's with full resolution. Things could be adjusted if needed, but this game feels great and it feels like it's running full speed. And that's it for this one. If you liked this video, don't forget to hit like and subscribe so you don't miss the giveaway announcement video. And until next time, remember, it doesn't matter if you make or break, so long as you're having fun.